Apple snuck in some shortcuts updates in iOS 17.4. In addition to some new actions on the iPhone, which I'll show you how to do some cool things with them, there's improvements on macOS and even new actions for Apple Vision Pro. First, let me show you the actions that are new to the iPhone and a couple use cases that make them really powerful. Here in the Shortcuts app, I'll just go to a new blank shortcut, and you can search for two different actions. One is orientation. Previously, you had to have a third-party application for this, but now Get Orientation is built into Shortcuts in iOS 17.4 and newer. Now, it might not look like this action does anything by itself, but if you pair this with an if statement, now you can determine what this shortcut will do depending on the orientation of your device. And all the different orientations are set up here in the menu. I'm going to give you some use cases specifically for this action in a moment. The other new action is really interesting. It's called Get Physical Activity. If I search for Get Physical, you'll see it show up here. It's actually in the workout section. Again, it doesn't look like this action is doing anything on its own, but if we add an if statement, now we can actually see the kind of information this action is going to surface. And then you can change what the shortcut does, depending on whether or not the iPhone is stationary, whether you're walking, running, or cycling, if you have one of those workouts running, and also in a stationary vehicle or in a moving vehicle. These two actions down at the bottom have really powerful implications, so I'm going to show you what to do with those in a moment. Let's go back to the orientation action, and if we choose Get Orientation, add that if statement, now we can program a few different things. So if orientation, and one of the easiest ones, this was really popular when the action button came out, let's do a landscape left, meaning the phone is going to be turned like this, holding it like if you were ready to take a picture. Then we can add another action. I'm going to choose my open app action. And also, if you're new to shortcuts, I have an entire shortcuts 101 video. I'll link it above and down in the description. And there's a whole playlist where you can walk through beginning to advanced shortcuts and automations. And it should be is. If orientation is landscape left, then I want to open and let's choose the camera app. This way, if my phone is sideways and this shortcut runs, it's going to open the camera. Now, programming this to the action button would be an easy win, but you can also program this to a home screen icon or even a back tap. Back tap can be a little awkward depending on the orientations you're programming, but you can still run the shortcut all those different ways. I'm going to add one more if statement, and when I tap the if result, I'll clear that. Then when I tap that blank input, I have the option to choose the orientation again. So if orientation is, and not only can you do portrait, landscape, you can also do face up or face down. So I'm going to choose face up. And for this if statement, I'm going to run another shortcut that I have. And this is where shortcuts gets really powerful, because now you can run shortcuts you've previously created and customized in new actions as they become available. So I'm going to put if orientation is face up, I'm going to run a shortcut that I have called super mute. You can learn about this super mute shortcut I created in my 13 action button shortcuts. I'll link that above and in the description. But basically, this mutes my device and turns the media volume all the way down. You know, sometimes your device might be on mute, but if you open YouTube or a social media app, video starts playing automatically. Well, just to show you what this shortcut looks like, I actually use a third-party app called Toolbox Pro, and it can detect whether or not silent mode is activated. And when you have an if statement, depending on whether it's activated or not, now the shortcut becomes a toggle, where it can toggle between silent mode off, which means now notification sounds will come through, and it sets my media volume to 50%, or if that stuff is enabled, it will enable silent mode, meaning no notification sounds, and set my media volume to 0%. Really love this super mute shortcut. So now I have this device orientation shortcut. So if it's in landscape left, it's going to open the camera. And if it's face up, like my phone is right now, it's going to run my super mute shortcut. Since it's face up, let's see if this works properly and runs my super mute shortcut. I'll hit the play button. It only does this the first time you're running a shortcut like that, but you'll see it change the volume and now silent mode is off, which means sounds will come through. And it did that because the orientation is face up. Now, if I press play again, it should run that face up if statement, meaning my super mute shortcut, and my super mute shortcut should toggle silent mode on and turn my media volume all the way down, which it did. So it's detecting properly that my phone is face up, and it ignored this first if statement because it's not in landscape left. But now let's test this. Of course, programming this to the action button will make it easier, but let's just play the shortcut right here to see if it actually works. And you can see it opened the camera because it detected that my phone is landscape left. Now, to get quick access to this shortcut, you can go to the Settings app, down to the Action button if you're on a 15 Pro or Pro Max. And then for the shortcut, we can choose the shortcut we just created. There's new in iOS 17.4. That's the shortcut I just named it. And let's test it out. So right now, my phone is face up. If I hit the Action button, it'll run that shortcut, which then runs my Super Mute shortcut. You'll see media volume got turned up right there. And if I run it again, it detects my phone is face up, runs my super mute toggle, and now my phone is muted. In the same way, now that my phone is landscaped left, I'll hit the action button, it detects the orientation, and now it went straight to the camera. Works great. Now, you could keep going and adding more if statements per orientation of your device. You could do portrait upside down, which is another interesting use case for super mute because that's usually how it is in your pocket. You can choose a different action for landscape right. Maybe you want to open the camera app left, but halide when it's landscape right. You can program all of these using a new if statement per orientation. And because this isn't using a third-party shortcut, I will link to this shortcut down in the video description so you could just download it and try it out on your iPhone. And again, if you don't have an action button, you can go ahead and add it to your home screen. This way it's easily accessible there. Now let's create a shortcut with the other new action, the Get Physical Activity. There's the new action, Get Physical Activity. I'll add an if statement. I'll choose is for that second step. And these are the different words this action will return. If your phone is just not moving at all, it'll do stationary. If you're running a workout like walking, running, or cycling, it'll return that. This is also a great action button shortcut. Let's say you want to open a specific cycling app once you've started a cycling workout. I can choose if physical activity is cycling, then open app, choose your favorite cycling app, and now if you hit the action button and trigger this shortcut and you're in a cycling workout, it'll open that app. Then you can put something in the otherwise, maybe like your super mute or some other action, and this gets pretty interesting. But I'm actually gonna choose a car action, and I'm gonna choose if in a stationary vehicle. That means CarPlay is enabled or your driving focus mode is enabled because your phone connected to the Bluetooth in your car. And I have another shortcut here which would be ideal for when I'm in the car. So I'm gonna choose the run shortcut action, and here I can choose the home ETA shortcut that I've built. My home ETA shortcut actually gets my home address, the travel time via driving, and then text that to my spouse. I have a whole video where I built the home ETA shortcut. Again, I'll link it above and down in the description. But now, if I'm in my car getting ready to head home, when I hit the action button, it will run this shortcut, Get Home ETA. Ideally, you should do that when you're not driving, so I'll leave that in a stationary vehicle. And then I'll actually add another if statement. I'll choose the if result. Let me clear that. And now I can choose the physical activity option again. Here I'll choose is in a moving vehicle. Now I have another shortcut which I recently built. I'm actually gonna duplicate the run shortcut action because it's just easier than searching for it again. Tap home ETA and then I can choose a different shortcut. This shortcut that I created skips forward 2 minutes to whatever media is currently playing on my iPhone. I do this because the built-in Apple Podcasts app only goes to a max of 60 seconds for skip forward, but using this, I can skip forward 2 minutes, and often ads are about 2 minutes or longer. Again, I'll link the video where I built that shortcut above and in the description. But now, when I get in my car, once my phone is connected to CarPlay or the Bluetooth, if I hit the action button or run this shortcut, it'll run my home ETA shortcut, which sends a text to my wife how many minutes it is until I arrive home. And if I'm in a moving vehicle, meaning the car is going, I'm listening to a podcast, and I want to fast forward 2 minutes, then the shortcut will do that. One shortcut can do both of these things, and I think this makes for some really powerful options in the car and whatever workouts like running, walking, or cycling. You can open specific apps, maybe open the fitness app. Really cool actions, and I'm glad Apple added these in 17.4. Apple also made some improvements to shortcuts on Mac. No new actions here, unfortunately. Still waiting for an automations tab, and hopefully folder automations will be coming in the next version of macOS. But when you have your shortcuts in list view like this, previously you couldn't just drag them into a folder, but now you can just click and drag these, put it in a different folder, and this works now in list view. But one that's even better is if you have a shortcut with a menu option, here like my social shortcut, where it just opens whatever social app. I use this more on my iPhone, but if you have a menu pop up on your Mac, you can now go up and down in the menu using the arrow keys on the keyboard rather than having to click on the mouse. Makes it a little faster when running shortcuts like this with the menu. And Apple Vision Pro also got some additional shortcuts. One of the most useful actions is now shut down. Previously, you had to hold the crown and the other side button for a few seconds, a number of seconds, and then you see the shutdown dialog, and then you can swipe. But with the shortcuts action, you can just have quick access to shut down if you want to disconnect the battery. And using the Shortcuts Buttons app, which I did an entire video on for Apple Vision Pro, you can check it out above or the links in the description. And Apple Vision Pro got some additional shortcuts like copy to clipboard. It'll recognize music. You can show definition when you have text selected or shared the input from a shortcut. And while it's still pretty tedious to build shortcuts on Apple Vision Pro, I'm glad these options are there. So that's what's new in shortcuts in iOS 17.4. Again, if you're new to shortcuts and maybe you're just getting started, definitely check out this video right here. It's my Shortcuts 101 video where I walk through kind of the very beginner steps of it. And then I have an entire playlist that goes through advanced shortcuts, automations, especially to save battery life. You can check out some of those in the description, and I'll put a video right here that YouTube thinks you'll really like. If you have shortcuts questions, and I have lots of requests building up from comments in past videos, I'm gonna be getting to those very soon, But if you have a Shortcuts request, something you hope Shortcuts can do, but you're not sure how to program it yet, leave a comment below this video. I'd love to help you there. Hit that like button and subscribe before you go. More Shortcuts videos coming very soon. And as always, thank you for watching. I'll catch you next time.